Hi and welcome to Kids Workshop. I keep on forgetting to record and everything. But yesterday we made these kind of, what shall we call them, towers to the first we made these I can take these up now. First we made the frame, the bottom frame here, and that's the one you see there where the towers is standing on. And yesterday we where do we place them? I cannot remember. Like this, something like this. And these we sawed yesterday. And go away. And the only thing I did today is I glued them this morning so that we had they could dry, so we could put can you see that part? Yes, you can see here. I have put a piece over here to strengthen it, and that we will do in a little while. But I will go to the next camera so you can see what that camera is kind of. No, what is it? Why is it? It's so. Kind of tilted. You can see what I'm doing here. Maybe we should take it a little bit out like this. Yes, see, I made a drawing on a cardboard so that it's easy to lay them up and make the strokes. But all of that you can see in episode 3 that I put up yesterday, and you can go to my site pixelfantasies.com, and there you can also see the drawing of the first frame, a bottom frame I made to put them on, and how we got this far. So now we will make a piece like the one up. Piece like the one up here, so that we get a little strength in here, and then we have to put something over here between the legs on the tower here, where we can put the pivot point in, where the it's all pivot around. So, but first thing first, and then we will what are we looking at now? We will look at this. So we will, no, I forgot my pencil, just a second. You can see it's better here as the finished product, the finished trebuchet but we will go to this and we'll turn this around. How did we do that? We did it that way. So you do like this, and we will put this up on it. And no, first I will see how I take a ruler and see how put that one over there. Here we have a ruler. So see how, whoops, how high this one is. And it's kind of 3.5 centimeters to the top of that. So we will make 3.5, 35 millimeters down here. So, and we will take our angle here. And make a stroke. And tomorrow I will make a couple of, we will make a couple of tools. We will make one of these in wood, and it will be as good as this one. And we will make another one, but I will tell you about it, because when you are sawing with a kind of saw like this, you want something to have it on. And so we will make some I will show it tomorrow. It's easier to understand when I do it in practice. I will make one before, and then I will make another one while we are working together. But today we will make this. So we'll make a piece that goes from something down there and to the top there. And but I will not cut this now, because if I do that, then I don't have anything to hold on when I'm sawing. So we will first do like this, make a little kind of in the middle here, like this. And put a thick finger on here. Maybe take it a little bit off. So, and then I will draw a line here and a line there. And then we should have one that fits that one. And I have made one of these so that we can hold everything while we are sawing, because it can be a little difficult on the table when we saw in those angles. Okay, and then we take our saw and can you see, not that far out. But when I do like this, you can. So, and the nail down against the wood, so you hold the blade up against the nail. Thank you. And now I have made, oops, not that good yet. When the groove is deep enough, you can do like I do here. Oops, that was not the goal. I will make it a little tight. But this is more or less with the grain, so, and that was what we saw yesterday. It's kind of hard to get through it. The teeth of this blade are kind of small. A little wiggly. See, can we get this one on too? Okay. But now it's kind of in the way. It takes way too long time. We will do it with the other salt buckets afterwards. But kind of not working like I wanted to. Thank you. think a new blade will do a difference. Come on. It's because I widened this out yesterday, so that really get it firm. But maybe that was a little too much. Thank you. I'll get through this one before I get through this one, I think. Thank you. It's because this saw supposed to do like this, whoops, do like this and not like this. So, but I thought I could because it's not that thick, but that's not gonna work. That's no solution to anything, but we will use another saw. But it's because I only want you to buy one saw. You can do everything with it. And I thought if you bought one of these, that was enough. But and it is, but you will be sawing a lot of days, so we will take this one. And because this will not this one is, if you see it from this side, it will bend in the middle like a hammock, and when you press like this, and this one won't do it. So what you need both, because but I will tomorrow when I make the new tool, so you can, when we get to the round one, you'll see how when it's this way it will work fine. Yeah. I thought that was possible. It wasn't. And also this tree is very fresh. Nowadays they don't store it the time. See, now we have a problem because we cannot do like this. Okay, then we do like this. Wood need to be stored before, but nowadays there's no time for that. They just get the bird of it and then gone home then. So have like on the other one, you can see here, okay, like this. If I remove my big fingers, but now you can see it down here. See, oops, mics, and I hope this. I have to keep checking. See, glue those on. Is it the same size? Yes. Glue that one on. This way you kind of strengthen the tower a little. But some of the things we are making on it are also just to look cool. Nothing wrong in looking cool. So I'll put a one of these on here. Come on. We'll make the next one, and that will not take that crazy amount of time. Oh, first we will first we will 35 millimeters. But it was bad. That is where here. You can see that, but I can see where it's kind of glued in the middle. And the same one as last time, but not in the same way. We will do it a bit different this time. Take this first. You have to make a little groove. Side so we can get room for the saw. Yes. So, and the same again. See the stroke. At least I can. Where are you? You are there. Don't. Thank you. this one. So, away with that, away with that. And this. I'm kind of disappointed that saw couldn't do it, but it couldn't. So there's nothing to do with that. But we also saw it when we did the other one, that it was not that good. But let me find other and better solutions. Eh? Do this one. Oops. Undo. The good thing about this glue, it dries fairly quick, so you're not have to stand around for a long time to wait for it to dry. And we'll take one more. Squeezer. You'll never get too many squeezers. And you always has to adjust it a little after you put the squeezer on, because it always want to move it around a little. So that was that. Then we will take this one. But first we will make a little measurement again. See, it may be easier to do it with this one. Six and a half down. And that means 6.5 down from the top of that. Don't use this one for that. 6.5 down from the that right. We'll try again. Six and a half. Six and a half. Yes. Six and a half. I see. It looks like there is a bigger room between there and there, but sorry. I'll do this for you guys, so you can see what I'm doing. And I make a long one, and the reason is then I have something to aim the ruler after. Of course, we only have to put the ruler. and we know they are nine, and those are nine. So 9 millimeters, we know the stakes are. So and we know I used two, so we need one more. Also nine, but I measured from the top, so it will be 18. Isn't that right? And the reason is that if I did this one, I did like I measured. So then I made this one after this one. So if I did a little wrong here, you can see not quite on the top of the mark. So if I do the next after this to this nine from here to here, then I repeat the wrongdoing at the first. So always measure from the first point if it's possible at all. Then you don't repeat errors down the line. See, that's how you do that. So what we need now is to make two pieces to fit in between, and we can already remove this one. Make two pieces that, what picture have you on? We have this picture on. Two pieces that fits in between here and there. Never stop that coughing. So, and just doing it for safety. So on, like that. And then I measure from here to down the middle here. And that is from the top of this to the top of that. Why is that? Five and a half. It needs to be 6 and a half. Yes. That's why I did wrong. This one is wrong. Away with that one. It might need to be 6 and a half. It's because I'm standing on my head here. I did it the wrong way. So we will do once again 6 and a half down from the top. From the top of this, and then the the room here will fit, will look more like I did it. So I could it on just hand side. So how do we do that? We do that like this and down on that's what's the good part of this, and then make a mark down here and the same. Sorry, put my head under the camera. It's a little okay. I'm going to do the same over here. So hit the mark. And then between there, and you take a stick. Don't we have any short ones? No, we have a short one here, or at least not that long. It's easier to work with when they are a little short. And now we have to ensure that they are the same. Oops. I can remember. So that's not the reason for that. See? Now we will do like this. Hey. Thank you. and need to do this. Should have one that fits up here. Yes, let me put some glue on. Table instead of where we want it to stick. So, see? This, when you draw this, is always a good idea because you are sure that you keep your angles right all the time, so it's not a waste of time to do it this way. And shall we take the next one after that? Okay. But then we have to make one more. And we did it wrong the first time. take this one. Take this one first. Like this. Oh, whoop. And like this. But you can see we use this all the time, so it was nice if we could. How does this fit? It fits because that was the way we took it. Go away. And this one should fit here because it's true here that the pivot point of the kind of sling doing. So we put glue on here and here and here. Now you can see it will be like we will take another camera and you can see this is what will come here and you can see it is pretty simple all the way through, but it's kind of when one look at this at the first time, then it looks a little more difficult. It looks worse than it is, but unfortunately, we have to stop now because I have another show. Stop motion. Stop in a minute. One. What is this? It's right there. One, two, put. Like this. It will fit over like this. This one will be the middle one. Up and stand there. And the next one here. See? Before you know it, we will have a trebuchet. And you also have this one. Like this. So, but we will get, the good part of it is that we can do this every day, so we will get there. And we are not cheating and having a lot of stuff under the table and say, whoop, boop, boop, and then we have it finished in 10 minutes. Nothing takes 10 minutes. Nothing worth to do takes 10 minutes, I guess. But anyway, I say thank you for today and hope to see you again tomorrow when we get to episode 5 of this build. I think we are on the 4 today. So goodbye and see you.